So folks, in this video, we're going to show you how you can connect Akiflow to ClickUp. It is a really helpful function when trying to consolidate a project manager with more of a task manager. And this video is kindly sponsored as part of our feature spotlight series with Akiflow. So you can find them linked below. Here is a guide to connecting them both.
This is naturally a consolidation tool because it's trying to bring in other experiences and other places that you might get tasks landing. This is why a lot of people are moving to Akiflow, because what it does more of is essentially bring all of those other project management applications to one space. And then it makes it easier to make your own view to it, if that makes sense. So you're sort of like pooling everything into one. So I'm gonna show you how you can connect it up with ClickUp. Now, in videos in the past, we've actually connected it with Notion and Todoist as good examples, but you can use some of the native integrations with the likes of Asana, Jira, Trello, Zoom, and even Gmail too, with the connection to Superhuman. So as you can see here, this is my ClickUp integration, and all you have to do is basically set up this integration by pressing in the application and following the instructions to connect your account. So you can see the information up here if you want to basically see how that connection works. Now, actually, I haven't set it up with a spaces, but we're going to demonstrate how that works. Now, you can also delete any or all of the tasks that are part of your Akiflow that have been imported to the application so far. And you can start from scratch by pressing restart too, which is a really nice function to just beginning from scratch so that you maybe don't get overwhelmed by everything that's come in. So I'm gonna go to spaces, and you can see that there are a few spaces. I actually want to refresh this because I recently created an Akiflow example. So that's great news, is that if you create something on their side, all you have to do is press refresh to basically get that free. So what I want to do is I want to bring in the tasks that are only assigned by me, but you can naturally see all of the tasks if you're that sort of person that wants to bring everything in one base. Now, you can also see the completion value, and you can set it to complete, and naturally the same here. Anything that's undone, you want to move to do. So you can change this and set it up in Akiflow which best suits the completion value needs. Now, as you can see here, you can select the scheduled date. Now, this is basically the scheduled experience that is in Akiflow at best suits you. So you might want it to set your start date to be that, which I tend to do, is always my start date. But in this case, we're gonna go with due date as a sort of goal to reach at the end. Now, we've also got a deadline day as well, but that can also be set as start date. But in this case, I'm selecting none because it won't bring that in if you select none, which is helpful. So if I go ahead and press save changes, now I can go back and configure this at any time, which is pretty helpful. And I can delete it too, or add more spaces, which is pretty helpful for bringing everything in. So here we are. I've got an item in my to-do area that is part of this Akiflow example. And I actually haven't assigned this to me yet, but say I was at work and I was assigning stuff and just giving a bit more context, I can open this up and see the details of it, of course. And naturally, if I was in work and I was managing this and I wanted my own way to see this, or it's been assigned to me by somebody else, then I can go back over to Akiflow now, making sure that I sync it, because of course it brings in other items as well. And naturally I'm going to press upcoming because it's set as tomorrow. Now, as you can see, it's brought this in from the Akiflow work, Akiflow example list, and you can actually open that link if you do want to. But this actually lives now inside of Akiflow as a worked example that I can completely utilize and take advantage of. It's also brought in the priority level, but I can add a whole host of more details to this and even go ahead and refine some of the details on it. Now, right now, it's actually assigned for 4 a.m. I'm sure that's part of the time zone of another country, so I'm going to bring it over to 9 a.m. I can also drag it out here, and as you can see, the details change inside of Akiflow, which gives me a bit more context to add, like deadlines, and also whether it's my goal of the day too. I can add description with more details, add labels as well to add more context here on this left-hand side, and finally add links that will give me more details about it. Now, you can bring in much more, and what's great is the inbox area can be a hub for all of this sort of stuff, which helps you to organize it if it's something that you haven't given a due date yet. But this is a great way to keep an eye on things that are scheduled inside of your calendar coming up and to be able to take advantage of it. I can see it here. And what's nice is I can actually, I've locked it into my calendar, but I can unlock it and move it about. So that's how to go about connecting up ClickUp, and you can have multiple tasks at once, be able to be coordinated here and from multiple locations, which is reasons why a lot of people like it, to be able to bring that, it's all in one place. So that was Akiflow and ClickUp, and hopefully it gave you a better idea of how it works. Thank you very much to Akiflow for sponsoring today's feature, and I'm sure we'll see you all in a future video. Cheerio, folks.